Hello. Good morning, everybody. Thanks for tuning in to Geering Up Live on this Wednesday at 11 o'clock. If you're new here, welcome. Thank you so much for joining. We stream every day, 11 o'clock, right here. So let me get us started by asking a very simple question. Have you ever wondered how glasses actually work and why we even need glasses? We're going to talk about that more on today's episode. Okay, so we already talked a little bit about how your eye works last week. And if you don't remember, you can go check out that video after this episode. Last week on either Thursday or Friday, we did an episode about how our eyes work. And we talked about optical illusions, 3D movies, and we learned about how light kind of bends into our eyes and lands on our retina. And today, we're going to expand on that idea, and we're going to talk about more advanced topics about your eye, okay? I saw a lot of people really interested about how your vision works and optics and, you know, glasses, contact lenses. I saw a lot of people had really interesting ideas that they would like to know about your eyes. So I just wanted to use today's episode to build on the foundation that we had last week and then go with some more advanced ideas today. So I hope today's episode challenges you a little bit. And we're also doing a really cool experiment with some lasers. Okay, so let's get started. Thank you everyone for tuning in. And let's watch this really funny commercial that I found that has to do with your glasses. See if you can follow along. So I don't know if anybody got that, but so basically the guy that was trying to catch the bowling ball, he couldn't tell that it was a bowling ball and he tried to headbutt it like a soccer ball. So that's the whole point of, do you need glasses? So hopefully that was funny. I thought it was hilarious coming from a guy that needs glasses. Okay, so the three big questions that we are gonna answer today are, what is nearsightedness and farsightedness? You guys hear this sometimes, right? When you go to your optometrist, what is nearsightedness? What is farsightedness? And we're gonna learn about how do glasses and contact lenses work. And then we're gonna test it out with some lasers, okay? And like I said before, we're gonna build on what we know from last week. So if you're new here and you're just watching for the first time, no worries, we're gonna go over a really quick review. And if you were here last week, you can leave in the comments or in the chat what you remember about last week's episode. Okay, so we're gonna go over really quickly the parts of our eye again. On the outside, we have the pupil that lets light in. And as light is traveling through our eye, it's traveling through mainly our cornea and our lens. And these are the two things that we're going to talk about today. These are the two things in our eye that is responsible for bending light onto our retina. Okay, and we talked about our retina. Our retina is in the back of our eye and it has photoreceptors that capture the light rays that are basically landing on it. So a picture here, we can see the cornea, which is on the outside of our eye, and then the lens, which is more on the inside, it's bending light in a certain way that it lands on the retina so that we can detect what object it is. So our first main question is, how do lenses actually do this, right? So how do lenses bend light a certain way so that it reaches our retina? Can anybody leave in the chat about how they think lenses and corneas do this? This is related to an episode that we've done all the way back in maybe season one, if you remember, or season two. I'll give you a couple seconds, but here's a hint. It has to do with refraction. And if you remember what refraction is, type it in the chat. So lenses and corneas can bend light a certain way because of refraction. And refraction is when light is bent at an angle through different materials, because light travels at different speeds through different objects, right? We talked about that. Light traveling through different speeds in different objects, and that's called refractions. And if you can go back to our episode 18, that's the one where I did a magic trick in front of you, where I put canola oil and made glassware disappear because light was bending the exact same way through those two objects. Okay, so in the same way that a lens can refract light, a lens can also focus light onto a certain point. And in physics, that point is called the focal point. Okay, I'm gonna say that again. So, in the same way that lenses can bend light, at a certain angle, the lenses can bend all light, so they focus on one point. And that's called the focal point. And if you notice, there's a certain length from the lens and the focal point. And that's what we call the focal length. And we're gonna learn why this is important to how our glasses and how our eyes work. And also, different curvatures of lenses can have different focal lengths. So if you see, the really wide lens has a shorter focal length, which means that all the light's focused closer to the lens. And if you have a very thin lens, thin curvature, that means your focal length is further away from the lens, which means that all the light is focused further away from the lens. Okay? And all of this is really important because our cornea and our lens function in that way. Our cornea and our lens focuses light so that it hits our retina. And we talked about how on our retina there's photoreceptors like cones and rods, right? So when light interacts with your retina, that's how you have the sensation of vision. So knowing this, we are gonna test it out. So can we try this out with what I have in this box and lasers? Okay, but first, this is really important. All right, in our couple previous episodes, we did safety checks that were, you know, we don't need to worry about too much because we're just using pencils and paper. But now, for our safety check, we have to be very careful because we're using a laser, okay? And I'll just shine it onto here, and you can see there's a red laser pointer. So today's safety check is you never, ever want to aim laser at someone's eye or airplanes, okay? If you're aiming this light, if this laser at someone's eye, you can actually cause them to go blind, okay? So never aim this laser at someone's eye. And don't aim it up at the sky at airplanes, because as you see on the picture there, it might actually be really disturbing to pilots, okay? So you don't wanna cause anything like that, all right? So we need to be really careful with lasers. Never aim them at anyone's eye or your own eye or airplanes, okay? So what is a laser actually? I'm gonna take a little detour. Did you know laser is actually an acronym? Acronym just means that the word stands for something. So LASER actually stands for light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. So that is what laser stands for. And we're gonna test out lens curvatures, right, with our laser. So if we look at this picture right here, we see that we have a lens. So I have a lens right here. This is what we call a convex convex lens, okay, or a converging lens. You see it bends outwards. I also have another type of lens called a concave lens. So concave, caves in, convex, goes outwards. Okay, so I have two types of lenses here. And what we want to do is we want to see if we can find the focal point of this lens. So we talked about the focal point, which means that all light rays coming into the lens are bending towards that one spot at a certain length away. Okay, so let's take a look to see if we can find that. So I have my board here, as you can see, and I have my laser right here. So without the lens, if I move the laser back and forth, right, you can see the laser pointer is moving back and forth. And Leonardo, great question. Is there a way to calculate a focal point? Yes, there is. That's a little bit more advanced physics. We can talk about that in the future if you'd like. It has to do with the curvature of the lens, but great question, Leonardo. Yes, you can calculate the focal length of a certain lens. That's a great question. So I have my laser here. I'm moving it back and forth, and the laser's moving back and forth, right? So no magic tricks here. So what I'm gonna do now is put this convex lens right here, and I'm not shining it through yet, so the laser's moving up and down. We wanna see if we can find one spot that the light will focus on, okay? So if I'm going further out here, the light is still moving up and down, so that's not really the focal point yet. If I move it closer, so you can start seeing how there's less movement, right? If I put it here, I believe this will be the focal point. So if you can tell, I'm moving my laser pointer up and down, but the light is not moving, right? I'm gonna show that one more time. Without the lens, the light is moving up and down. With the lens, the light is not moving at all, even though my laser pointer is moving up and down, right? So that's actually the focal length from here to here, and what you see there is the focal point. And that's going to be really important when we talk about our eyes and glasses, okay? Focal lengths and focal points. So as you can see here, the laser is not really moving like before, because we're really close to the focal length. And then if we go sideways like this, I'll show the same thing. We're going sideways, right? No lens, it's moving back and forth. And now we have a lens right here. And let's take a look. So this is not the focal length because it's still moving. But if we get closer, we might be able to find a good spot right here. You see how the light is not moving? That means the lens is focusing all the rays onto that one point. So just like the image, the lens is focusing all of the rays onto one point, which is the focal point. Okay? And then also, if I use a different type of lens, like this one right here, you can see that the focal point is not the same as before. Right? It's still moving regardless. This one even bends even more. And we're going to talk about the different types of lenses and how they work. So this one does not have a focal point in front of the lens. Okay? So now that we know how that works, let's talk about how your eyes can change lens curvature. So we see that if we want to focus on things that are close or further, we would need to adjust the curvature of our lens in order to focus light onto our retina. And how do we do that? How do your eyes actually do that? Well, your eyes on your lenses, they actually have these muscles called ciliary muscles. And what these muscles do is they either relax or contract. And when these muscles contract, your lens gets bigger and light gets focused closer. And when your muscles relax, your lens gets thinner and light gets focused further away. Okay, so that's actually how your lens inside your eye is changing the curvature, changing the thickness in order for light to properly bend into your eye. Okay? And now my question to you is, have you ever been to an optometrist to get your eyes checked, right? I need to get my eyes checked all the time because I have terrible eyesight and I need my glasses. So I go to the optometrist a lot. And that brings me to my question now. Knowing how lenses work and how light is bent into your eye, can you think of why, you know, you might have nearsightedness or farsightedness regarding to your lens? I want to see what you think in the chat. So why do you think some people are nearsighted and some people are farsighted? What's happening with the lens, do you think? Do you think if you have nearsightedness and farsightedness that your lens is behaving normally or like abnormally? This is your eye's lens, right? And we talked about how lenses can be bigger or smaller based on the muscles in your eye. What actually happens is if you have a vision disorder like a myopia or hyperopia, which is myopia is nearsightedness, hyperopia is farsightedness, what happens is your lens isn't focusing light properly. Okay, so in myopia, which is nearsightedness, which means you can see things up close, it means that your lens is focusing light too close ahead. So that means your focal point, right, your focal length is closer to the front than your retina. Okay, and if you have hyperopia, which means that you can see things that are further away but not things that are close, it means that your lens is focusing light too far back. Okay, and astigmatism, which is what I have, which means that there's just a lot of things going on, like your cornea is not shaped the right way, or even your eye. Okay, so those are the four main sort of vision problems that we come in contact with on a day-to-day basis, right? And I would like to say that these are things that are very, very common. So if you have nearsightedness or farsightedness, don't worry, right? It's because we have glasses. That's what these glasses are for, okay? And what can cause these vision disorders? Well, mainly the big one is through genetics, right? A lot of how your eyes shaped or your lenses are shaped is because of genetics. And also because of age, as you get older, your eyesight might deteriorate. And also trauma. If you're scratching your eye a lot and really hard, or there's dirt or dust particles getting into your eye excessively, that could cause damage to your cornea. And smoking and staring at the sun are also really bad for your eyes, and you should never do that. Okay, so now we're gonna talk about how your glasses work. Now that we know that vision disorders come from the fact that your lenses are not bending light the way they should be, either too far or too close, how do glasses work? Well, glasses and contact lenses work on the same sort of technology. Basically, glasses are lenses that are in front of your eye that help adjust the way that light gets bent into your eye so that when it hits your lens and your cornea, it bends properly into your retina. So glasses and contact lenses are pretty much just like these lenses, except very, very small. So as we can see in the picture above, based on different types of vision disorders, you're gonna need different types of lenses. That's why going to an optometrist is so important, to get the right prescription. Okay, so for example, if it's something like hyperopia, where light is being bent too far back, you need to have a lens that looks like this, like a convex lens to bend light closer. Okay, so let's talk a little bit now about the future of glasses and contacts. We know how glasses and contacts work, but here are some really cool things that are happening in the future for contact lenses. So now Google is actually developing a smart contact lens with a chip inside the lens, as well as like an antenna. So you can make phone calls, you can have Google Maps, you can have images right in your contact lens. And also in the same way, people are starting to develop smart glasses, glasses that you can text with, that you can navigate, you can Google images. It's super, super duper cool. So even if you have if you don't have glasses now and you have perfect vision, we might have technology in the future that lets your glasses be used like a smartphone. So everyone might start wearing glasses, right? So I'm gonna show you a video now about a really cool company that's working on a pair of smart glasses. And I want to see what are some things that you can pick up from there, okay? So let's watch this video together.
These glasses will cost you $600. They're actually smart glasses called Focals, made by the Canadian startup North. Focals are meant for everyday use, and their main purpose? To make you rely less on having to pull out your phone. But these notifications and other information right in front of your face. Just like smartphones, but faster and arguably more convenient. But is it really as good as it seems? I wanted to see if smart glasses really will replace a smartphone, or if it's just all hype. Watch out, New York, Alex.
So if you're interested in seeing more of that video, you can go on YouTube and search up smart glasses and you can see what they do. They're super cool. They can show you directions, they can show you maps, and then your text messages. So this might be the future of correction lenses, right? And that's super cool. We can all have our computer right in our eye or on our glasses, okay? And Leonardo, I see your question about astigmatism. I'll answer that question right after the video. But first, I want to talk about one last thing before we go, and that's laser eye surgery. So some of you have heard of laser eye surgery. I want to talk about more about what that is. So LASIK eye surgery actually stands for laser-assisted in situ keratomyelitis, okay? You don't need to know what that word means. I just thought it was kind of cool. And what laser eye surgery does is a doctor basically kind of opens up your cornea and then shines a laser in there to fix the way that your lens or your cornea is bending light, right? So when we talked about how our vision works, remember, cornea and lens are super important to bend light into our eye, right? So what laser eye surgery does is, if you have a vision disorder where your lens and cornea is not bending light the right way, what they do is they cut it open, shine a light in there that somehow fixes the way your lens and cornea is bending light. So because of LASIK eye surgery, the future might be that everyone can get their vision fixed. Right? Technology is so, so awesome. And, you know, we can start using this really cool technology to for medical purposes, right? So thank you everyone for joining today. I want to just recap by saying three quick things. That first of all, our eyes are amazing organs, as we learned last week already. They function with so many parts. And today we talked more about the lens and the cornea, right? And our lens and the cornea, what it does is it focuses light onto our retina. And then we also talked about lenses in real life, right? Lenses like our glasses and contact lenses. All these do is to bend light into a focal point so that we can see better. In the same way, we didn't really talk about this, but we can extrapolate and say that binoculars and telescopes use the same concept of lenses in order to bend light from really far away so that it reaches our eye focused. Okay? Thank you everyone for joining me today. I hope you had fun and enjoyed seeing the little lens demo with lasers. And I'm gonna answer some questions now that we have here. Leonardo has a question asking, do we have to have a blind spot? So yes, Leonardo, as we talked about last week, we have to have a blind spot because our blind spot is basically light that hits our optic nerve, our optic disc, right? And we need to have an optic nerve in order to see, because that's the nerve that carries information from our eye into our brain. And Kevin also asked, what are the types of lenses? The two main types of lenses that I have here are a convex lens right here and a concave lens right here. So those are the two main types. But if you actually look at this one here, you can see the astigmatism glasses, they use, you know, maybe a combination or even a different type of lens. But these are the two main ones, okay? And Leonardo, another question, great question, you say, how do you know what shape of lens to make for astigmatism? So that is where your optometrist comes in. That's where your eye doctor comes in, right? So what eye doctors do for astigmatism is they take measurements of your eye, they take measurements of your cornea, of your lenses, how your eye is actually shaped. And then with those measurements, they can know how to make glasses that bend light properly into your eye. So that's all because of your eye doctor. Okay? And Leonardo says, what if you put a concave and a convex together? What will happen? That's a great question. And I'm curious about that too. So we can actually try this out. I haven't tried it out yet, but Leonardo, if you're still here, let's take a look. So I have my board right here. And then I have my convex, concave, and they actually fit really nicely together. So I want to take a look right now. Let's see what happens right here. So normal, I guess it kind of gets reset, right? It becomes almost like nothing has changed because the light is bending one way in and then one way out again. So super cool suggestion, Leonardo. Like, it doesn't look like a convex nor a concave on its own because those are different. And then we put them together, they look as if there was no lens. That's really cool, Leonardo. Thank you so much for that great question. I actually didn't know that, so I'm glad I tried that out today. Okay, awesome. So thank you everyone for joining me, and I will see you all tomorrow. Have a wonderful day, everyone.